हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन सीईटी नीट एंड जेईई क्लासेस। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम थ्योरेटिकल कॉन्सेप्ट्स व्हिच आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर सीईटी एंड नीट एग्जामिनेशन ऑन द टॉपिक थर्मोडायनामिक्स। स्टूडेंट्स, थर्मोडायनामिक्स इट इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स। Basically, thermo means heat and dynamics mean moment. It is the branch of chemistry. Usually, thermodynamics, it comes under thermochemistry. Thermochemistry, it is the branch of physical chemistry which deals with the study of thermal changes accompanying a physical or chemical transformation. Students, you know, according to the law of conservation of energy, total energy of the system and its surrounding remains constant. In this chapter, we mainly concentrate on heat changes, right? Students, there are three thermodynamic terms. What are those? System, boundary, and surroundings. Thermodynamics, the branch of science which deals with the study of interconversion of heat or transformation of energy, right? Yes, what are those three common terms used in thermodynamics? In that, first one is system. What is system? Students, it is the part of the universe which is under thermodynamic study. What is the term system? It is the part of the universe which is under thermodynamic study. Remember, a thermodynamic system, it is defined as a definite space or a definite area on which the study of energy transfer and energy conversions made. Simply, you remember what is system? It is the part of the universe which is under thermodynamic study. If you take an example, a beaker containing water is called system. A beaker which containing water. Here water is the system because we concentrate on the beaker. It is under thermodynamic study. Next, another one, boundary. What is boundary here? The real or imaginary surface. Real or imaginary surface which separates the system and surrounding. Usually, this boundary, it indicates an imaginary surface that separates the system and surrounding. What is boundary system? Students, what is boundary? The system and surrounding, they are separated by this term. It may be fixed or movable or imaginary. It will not occupy any volume or mass in the space. Next, another one term, surroundings. What is surroundings? It is the part of the universe which exclude the system. It is the part of the universe which excluding the system. If you take an example, water in a beaker. Here the water is the system and air around the beaker act as a surrounding. Anything outside the system which affects the behavior of the system is known as surrounding. Next, another two terms, control volume. What is control volume? A specified large number thermal device has mass flow in and out of the system. Remember the definition point. What is control volume? It is a specified large number thermal device which has mass flow in and out of the system is called control volume. And next one, control surface. Both mass and energy can cross the boundary of a control volume which is called control surface. See this diagram, it clears what is the system, what is surrounding, and what is the term boundary. See here, this part, it is under thermodynamic study. This part is under thermodynamic study, right? So it is an system. And boundary, here it is the imaginary surface which separates the system and surrounding, right? Therefore it is the boundary and surrounding, it is the part of, sorry, except system which comes under the universe is act as a surrounding. Next, another very important terms, classification of thermodynamic system. There are usually 3 to 4 types of system are observed. In that first one I take open system. What is open system? Remember students, open system, here it exchange both energy and mass from the surroundings. Open system, here it exchange both energy and mass from the surroundings. If you take an example, trees in a forest, tea in a open cup. Remember, trees in a forest, tea in a open cup. These are some examples for open system. Here both system and surroundings, it exchange themselves. Next, closed system. Here observe open system point 1, in which both energy and mass cross the boundaries of the system because they can exchange. Then second one, closed system. What is closed system? Here it exchange only energy with the surrounding. It is an example for closed system. If you take another example, water in a closed bottle. Water in a closed bottle. Here boundaries of a closed system act as a conductor of heat. Yes, what is closed system, students? One in which mass does not cross boundary of the system, though energy may do so. Yes, next, another type of system, that is isolated system. What is isolated system? A system that cannot exchange mass and energy. Both mass and energy here does not change with its surroundings. Milk kept in a thermoplast. It is the best example for isolated system. What is isolated system? One in which neither mass nor energy crosses the boundaries of the system. You see here these diagrams. Here A, it is an example for open system, and B, here closed system. Isolated system, it is observed in C diagram. Right, here why it is an example for open system? A, because here matter, it is in open space. S, in closed system, and C, it indicates isolated system. Next, state of a system and state variables. I think you know in theoretical classes, what is state of a system? Remember, a state of a system, it is determined by its observable properties. State of the system, it is usually determined by observable properties. The system in which the values of observable properties are definite is said to be in definite state. Is definite, sorry, state of a system, students. The state of a system, usually at standard temperatures like 298 temperature and pressure of 101325 Pascal, is called standard state of a system. Right. But now the point is state of a system. Students, remember, the system is said to be in certain state when all its properties like pressure, volume and temperature, mass, composition, etc., they may be fixed. They are fixed. Yes, remember, state of a system, they are the condition of a system which described in terms of certain measurable properties such as temperature, pressure, volume, etc. of the system. State variables. The state of a system is specified by state functions or state variables. What are those variables? Those are like pressure, volume, temperature. These are also called as state variables or state functions, because their values depend only on the state of a system and not on how it is reached. Yes, next, another point. Homogeneous system. What is homogeneous system? Remember, students, in this type of system, only one phase is observed. It contains only one phase system. Single component system. If you take an example, zinc, oxygen, water. Here, single component is observed. Here, solution, miscible liquid. Solution, miscible liquid. Take an example, water and alcohol, or NaCl and water. Homogeneous system, it contains solution, miscible liquid. Water and alcohol is the composition. Yes, it is an example for homogeneous system. NaCl and water, it gives the homogeneous system. Mixture of gases, hydrogen gas, nitrogen gas, oxygen gas, mixture of these gases also an example for homogeneous system. Because if you observe several years, the composition of gases becomes same, it remains same. Next, heterogeneous system. Here, two separated phase. Heterogeneous system, it is separated by boundary. Here, mixture of immiscible liquid is observed, water and benzene. It gives an example for heterogeneous system. Solid identical with liquid here. Solid, it is identical with liquid. Ice and water, it is an example. Liquid identical with its vapor. Water and vapor is the example. All these are some example for heterogeneous system. You know, homo means same, same composition. Hetero means different, different composition in a system. Next, isothermal process. What is isothermal process? Remember, the process in which the state of a system gets changed from one state to another state. Isothermal process, it is the process in which the temperature of the system remains constant. In isothermal process, temperature of the system remains constant. Usually in this process, the boundaries of the system are mobile. Mobile means movement. The energy released in the exothermic process is absorbed by the surroundings, and if the process is endothermic, the system takes the required energy from the surrounding. Therefore, temperature in this particular process, it remains constant. The change in the temperature means delta T or dT, it is equal to 0. See here, temperature of the system here, delta T equal to 0. Usually in this process, temperature at initial state and final state, it is constant because there is no change in the temperature. In isothermal process, the system exchange heat energy with its surroundings to maintain a constant temperature. Usually in isothermal process, one of the system, it exchange heat energy with its surroundings. Why? Because to maintain the constant temperature. Yes, isothermal process, it occurs in closed system. Here, there is no change in the internal energy. Therefore, internal energy of the system remains constant here. It is indicated by delta U equal to 0. Delta U equal to 0. Students, usually in isothermal process, gaseous system, pressure, volume of a change. Remember, this one is very important point, isothermal process. Next, reversible process. What is reversible process? The process is slow and unreal. The process, which one is slow and unreal, its direction can be changed at any step, and during the process of every stage, system remains in equilibrium with its surrounding. Remember this point. What is reversible process? Usually, the process, it is one of the slow process, and its direction can be changed at any step during the process. Remember, system remains in equilibrium with its surroundings in this reversible process. A process which is carried out in such manner that every stage, the driving force is only infinite greater than the opposing force, and it can be reversed by an infinite increase in opposing force, and the system exists in equilibrium with its surrounding, is called reversible process. Remember, it is one of the slow process, and infinite number of steps are involved here. Next, irreversible process. What is irreversible? This is the process which one is fast process and gets completed in a single step. Remember, irreversible process, it cannot be reversed. All the natural processes are an example for irreversible process. Yes, remember students, very important. Irreversible process, it is unidirectional process, means there is no particular direction, unidirectional process, which proceeds in a definite direction and cannot be reversed at any stage, and in which driving force and opposing force differ in a large magnitude. This irreversible process is also called as spontaneous process. They are real process, not hypothetical. Example, flow of heat from high temperature to low temperature. Next, isochoric process. What is isochoric process? The process in which a system proceeds via many intermediate steps and returns to the initial state. What is cyclic process? It is one of the process in which system proceeds via many intermediate steps and returns to the initial state. Change in the internal energy delta U equal to 0, change in enthalpy means delta H is equal to 0 in a cyclic process. Yes, now the point is isochoric process. The process which takes place at constant volume, means there is no change in the volume, delta V means change in the volume, it is equal to 0, means there is no change in the volume. See here, isochoric process, here they given delta V means there is no change in the volume, hence system does not perform any mechanical work. Therefore, W equal to, you know formula, W equal to minus P into delta V. Here P is the pressure and this delta V is change in the volume, it is equal to 0. As you know, one equation, delta U equal to Q plus W. Q is charge and W is the work done. So delta U equal to QV, because W here it is 0. So QV here, heat absorbed at constant volume, delta U and Q are two state functions. Next, adiabatic process. What is adiabatic process? Students, in a closed system, you know, heat is not exchanged by its surroundings, right? In a closed system, heat is not exchanged by its surroundings. The system is in isolated state. In this process, temperature can increase and can decrease also, means there is a change in the heat, dQ, right? Remember, in adiabatic process Q equal to 0. Therefore, delta U equal to Q plus W, then delta U equal to W. Here Q is 0. Yes, system expansion during the adiabatic process. Yes, what happens? Delta U means change in the internal energy decrease, internal energy and temperature of the system also decrease. System compression. Here delta U increase means change in the internal energy is increases. Internal energy and temperature of the system increases. Yes, see here, there are three measurements in temperatures. One is in Kelvin scale, another one is degree Celsius, and another one Fahrenheit. Right? 373 means it is the Kelvin temperature, 100 degree Celsius, 212 degree Fahrenheit. Boiling point of water at atmospheric pressure. Yes, these three formulas are very useful to convert the temperature of one form to another form. Yes, temperature in Kelvin scale. If you want to temperature in presence of Kelvin scale, yes, degree Celsius value, it is added with 273 value. Then you get Kelvin scale. Yes, another formula, TC equal to means temperature in degree Celsius equal to 5 by 9 TF means Fahrenheit scale minus 32. Yes, they given Fahrenheit values or they given the temperature in Fahrenheit value, then by using this formula you can convert it into the degree Celsius. Yes, if they given the temperature in presence of degree Celsius value, then by using this formula, what is the formula? TF equal to 9 by 5 TC plus 32. By using this formula, you can convert degree Celsius value into Fahrenheit scale. Yes, freezing point of water. In Kelvin scale, it is 273.15 and Celsius scale, it is 0 degree Celsius, and in Fahrenheit scale, it is 32 degree Fahrenheit. Yes, internal energy as a state function. Internal energy. What is internal energy? The fixed amount of energy stored in a substance. Remember, the fixed amount of energy stored in a substance is called its internal energy. Internal energy, it is present in all the substance. Remember students, internal energy is a state function and depends on the physical state of the system, and it is independent of method by which state has been attained. Internal energy is the state function and it depends on the physical state of the system. And internal energy, it is the total of all type of energy. If you take an example, potential energy, kinetic energy, vibrational energy, rotational energy, the sum of all these terms is equal to internal energy. Yes, see these, see the given points. Internal energy of system is defined as U. Usually internal energy is indicated by U. Delta U means change in the internal energy. This internal energy may be electrical, chemical or mechanical. The thermal energy U of the system, which may change, it may differ. Heat passes into or out of the system. Work is done on or by the system. Matter enters or leaves the system. Students, remember, absolute value of internal energy cannot be determined. Only change in the internal energy can be determined. Delta E means change in the internal energy, delta E or delta U, it is equal to energy of the final state minus energy of the initial state. Or it may be also written as delta U equal to U2 minus U1. Final state minus initial state. Change in internal energy. Yes, next, work. Yes, all kinds of work is expressed as W equal to minus P into delta V. You know this formula, I write here. W equal to minus P into delta V. Right. W equal to minus P delta V. Work is one of the way by which a system can exchange energy with its surrounding by changing the state of the system. Work is one of the way by which the system can exchange its energy with its surrounding by changing the state of the system. Yes, observe this equation W equal to minus P delta V. The above expression it satisfies by sign conventions. For example, delta V means it is V2 minus V1. Here delta V it is positive and W is negative. For compression, delta V means V2 minus V1 it is negative, then W is positive. Remember students, work done by the system on the surrounding, work done by the system on the surrounding minus W is negative, or work done by the system on the surrounding, here W is equal to negative, and work done on the system by the surrounding W equal to positive. This kind of work in chemical thermodynamics, you know, the one equation W equal to minus Px V2 minus V1. The type of work is mechanical work done. Is that pressure volume work? You know this equation W equal to minus Px. Here it indicates external pressure into change in the volume V2 minus V1. Students remember, here P external, it is the external pressure applied, and V2 minus V1 it indicates change in the volume. Remember, work is also contained due to chemical process or reaction. Work is also obtained due to chemical process or a reaction. Expression for pressure volume work. See here, if A is the cross section area of the cylinder, A is one of the area of the cylinder or piston, then you know W equal to minus F by A. F is, it means force, A in the area, S D displacement or distance into A area. Now the pressure is P external equal to F by A, and delta V means change in the volume equal to dx A. So we get final equation W equal to P external into delta V. Yes, next another term, heat. Students, we can also change the internal energy of a system by transfer some amount of heat from the surroundings to the system or vice versa. Remember, we can also change the internal energy of a system by transferring some amount of heat from the surrounding to the system or vice versa. This exchange of energy, which is result of temperature difference, is called heat. Usually heat is indicated by Q. As if you consider the same change in the temperature by transfer of heat through thermal conducting valves instead of adiabatic valves. Yes, remember these concepts. Heat absorbed by the system. Heat absorbed by the system means plus Q is equal to positive. Heat released by the system is negative. If heat absorbed by the system, then Q value is positive. Heat released by the system, here Q is negative. Q is positive when heat is transferred from the surroundings to system, and Q is negative when heat transferred from the system to surrounding. Yes, next, first law of thermodynamics. First law of thermodynamics is also called as law of conservation of energy. According to this law, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. According to first law of thermodynamics, Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can only change from one form to another form. If you take total energy of a isolated system remains constant here. Total energy of the universe also remains constant. Whenever some amount of any form of energy, it may disappear. The same amount of energy is produced in another forms. Students, remember, first law of thermodynamics, it is the law of conservation of energy. One kind of energy is consumed, another kind of energy may disappear here. It is impossible to construct a particular motion machine. Here, you know, a formula U equal to Q plus W. Here, U is internal energy. It is equal to heat plus work. Total amount of work is converted into heat energy. Yes, mathematical expression for first law of thermodynamics. Here energy is absorbed by the system plus Q and work is done on the system plus W. Internal energy of the system increases here if U1 is the initial value, internal energy, and U2 is the final, U2 minus U1 plus Q plus W. This is the expression. You see here, U2 equal to U1 plus Q plus W. U2 means internal energy of the state 2 and internal energy of state 1 plus heat plus work. U2 minus U1 equal to Q plus W. Therefore, delta U, U2 minus U1, that is delta U equal to Q plus W. This one is very important, delta U equal to Q plus W. This formula helps to calculate the internal change in the internal energy. S for infinite small change in the mathematical expression is delta U equal to or du equal to dq plus dw. Change in the internal energy is always equal to change in the heat and change in the work done. Change in the internal energy is the sum of change in the heat and change in the work done by the system. Yes, first law of thermodynamics for various processes. First law of thermodynamics, in presence of isothermal process. Remember, in isothermal process, delta T equal to 0 means there is no change in the temperature. Here, system depends on the temperature. There is no change in the internal energy of the system. Therefore, delta U, they given delta U equal to 0 means there is no change in the internal energy. Therefore, internal energy means change in the internal energy, it is equal to heat plus work done. Therefore, there is no change in the internal energy. Delta U equal to 0. Therefore, 0 equal to Q plus W. Q, expansion, then minus work. Right, means negative work done. Or W equal to minus Q. This consumed. Remember, students, in presence of isothermal process, energy change in the system is equal to heat given to the system plus work done on system. Next, first law of thermodynamics for various process, in that isobaric process. Yes, in isobaric process, change in the pressure is zero, means there is no change in the pressure. Here system performs the work of a expansion due to volume change. Here W equal to external pressure into delta V means change in the volume. Remember this expression, W equal to change in the external pressure into change in the volume. Here QP, it is heat absorbed by the system at constant pressure. Yes, you know, delta U equal to Q plus W, delta U equal to Q minus W is here, P external into delta, we substitute that value. Then QP equal to delta U plus P external delta P. Remember this formula also. QP, heat absorbed, used to increase the internal energy of the system. Yes, next another concept, free expansion. What is free expansion? Students, expansion of a gas in a vacuum. Remember, expansion of a gas in a vacuum. Here, external pressure is nil. Means there is no change in the external pressure. That is called pre-expansion. Simply, expansion of a gas in a vacuum is called pre-expansion. Yes, expansion of a gas in vacuum is called pre-expansion. Remember, during this process, no work is done during free expansion of an ideal gas, whether the process is reversible or it may be irreversible. Remember here, we know that W equal to P external means external pressure into change in the volume, right? Therefore, the internal energy delta U equal to Q minus P external means external pressure. You know this equation, change in the internal energy is equal to Q minus means heat minus external pressure into delta U. Therefore, delta U equal to QV, change in the volume. QV denotes heat is supplied at constant volume. Here QV, it indicates heat is supplied at constant volume. These formulas are very important to solve the multiple choice questions. Next, enthalpy or heat content. Yes, what is enthalpy? The total heat content of a system at constant pressure. Remember, the total heat content of a system at constant pressure is known as its enthalpy. Usually, it is indicated by the symbol H. If they given delta H means change in the enthalpy. You know, and remember this expression, this is very important. Delta H equal to delta U plus P delta V, right? What does this term indicates? Delta H means change in enthalpy. Delta U means, you know, change in the internal energy. P delta V, here delta V, change in the volume, right? This P, it is the pressure. P, usually here it is external pressure. Remember students, most of the chemical reactions occur at constant pressure, usually 1 atmospheric pressure, and in open vessel. Thus measured, the value of heat evolved or absorbed is enthalpy change. Here delta V equal to 0, delta H is equal to delta E or delta U. Yes, we know that heat absorbed at constant volume, it is equal to the change in the internal energy. But most of the chemical reactions are carried out not at constant volume, but in flasks or test tubes under constant atmospheric pressure. Yes, very important, extensive and intensive properties. In that, first I take extensive properties term. The properties, what are extensive properties? The properties which depend on the amount of substance present in the system. Very important. The properties which depends on the amount of substance which are present in the system. If you take an example, mass, volume, heat, capacity, entropy, enthalpy, pre-energy, internal energy, all these are an example for extensive property. Next, another term, I think you already heard about intensive property. Usually these are the properties which are independent of the amount of substance present in a system. Example, temperature, density, viscosity, melting point, boiling point, very important, surface tension, refractive index, pressure, all these are intensive properties. Remember students, an extensive property, it is the property which value depends on the quantity or size of the matter in a system. and intensive property is the property which does not depend on the some amount of substance, temperature, density. All these are examples. Yes, next, heat capacity. Yes, what is heat capacity of a system? It is the amount of heat required to rise the temperature of a system by 1 degree Celsius. Usually, heat capacity of a system, it is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of the system by 1 degree Celsius. Usually, heat capacity of a system, it is calculated by using formula C equal to Q divided by M into T2 minus T1. In case of single substance, here M equal to 1, C is specific heat of a system. See this formula. Here I write once again this formula. C equal to Q divided by M into T2 minus T1. Here, if you take M equal to 1 gram, then C is the specific heat value of a system, where M equal to M gram or 1 mole of substance, it is the molar heat capacity. Yes. The magnitude of the coefficient depends on the size, composition and nature of the system. See this term. The specific heat capacity of a substance Q equal to C into M into delta T. It is always equal to C into delta T, change in the temperature, where mass remains constant. Yes, next, very important, you also derived in theory class the relationship between Cp and Cv. What is the relation? Cp and Cv, Cp minus Cv equal to R. Remember students, at constant volume, heat capacity C at a constant volume is denoted by Cv. Carefully read the points. And at constant pressure, it is denoted by Cp. Constant pressure, constant value. Yes. The relationship between them is follows. Qv equal to Cv delta T equal to delta U. At constant pressure, Qp equal to Cp delta T. Constant pressure, change in the temperature is equal to change in the enthalpy. Now, the difference between Cv and Cp can be derived for an ideal gas for 1 mole of a gas. You know this expression. Here, if 1 mole of an ideal gas is taken, then delta H, change in the enthalpy, is equal to change in the internal energy and change in the pressure volume. Therefore, delta UV plus delta U plus delta RT. Delta U plus R delta T. Therefore, delta H equal to delta U plus R delta T. Now substitute values, we get Cp delta T Cv delta T plus R delta T. So therefore, Cp equal to Cv plus R, or Cp minus Cv equal to R. Derive this expression in your theory class. But remember, what is the relationship between Cp and Cv? That is Cp minus Cv equal to R. Yes, next, measurement of delta U and delta H calorimetry experiments. Right. I think by using two experiments, that is expansion as well as compression of a form of mechanical work, right? This is also called pressure volume type of work then. Yes, energy changes can be measured with chemical or physical processes by an experimental technique is called calorimetry. Usually in this process, a vessel called calorimetry is immersed in a known amount of liquid, and knowing the heat capacity of liquid in which calorimetry is immersed and the heat capacity of the calorimeter, is possible to determine the heat evolved by measuring the temperature changes under two conditions, at constant volume Qv and constant pressure Qp. Yes, I think you know one very important point. In presence of calorimetry experiment, measurement of change in internal energy, that is the delta U, you remember one concept. Heat given out, usually heat evolved is calculated by using this equation. Heat evolved equal to heat absorbed by the calorimeter plus heat absorbed by water. Yes, at the bomb calorimeter experiment, it is sealed, its volume does not change. Hence, the heat of combustion at constant volume, remember this point, heat of combustion at constant volume is obtained, which is equal to delta U. Therefore, QV equal to delta U is measured. Next, in presence of measurement of change in enthalpy, means delta H, here the boiling tube is open to the atmosphere, hence pressure remains constant. Therefore, heat of a reaction at constant pressure is measured here, that is QP equal to delta H. Yes, enthalpy change of a reaction or reaction enthalpy. In a chemical reaction, the reactants are get converted to products and they are represented by reactants to products. Yes, in the every reaction it involves reactants, and if the reaction takes place, means the reactants are get converted to product, right? Yes, they also given here. Reactants get converted to product. The enthalpy change accompanying in a reaction is called reaction enthalpy. The enthalpy change of a chemical reaction is denoted by delta H or delta RH. Here R it indicates reaction. As delta RH is equal to sum of the enthalpies of all the products minus sum of the enthalpies of the reactants. Standard enthalpy of formation. Students, what is enthalpy of a reaction? It is the amount of enthalpy or energy evolved or absorbed when a number of moles of a reactants are represented by balanced chemical equation. It is usually completely reacted. But the point is, standard enthalpy of a reaction. Change in the enthalpy of a reaction at 25 degrees Celsius is called enthalpy of a reaction. Means if it is 25 degrees Celsius, then it is in Kelvin scale, it is 298. Right. The standard enthalpy change for a formation, the standard enthalpy change for the formation of one mole of a compound from its elements in their most stable state aggregation is called standard molar enthalpy or standard molar formation. Yes, next, thermochemical equations. Yes, what are thermochemical equations? These are the balanced chemical equations together with the value of delta H, means delta R is the given. Here it indicates change in the enthalpy of a reaction called a thermochemical equation. Point to remember in a thermochemical equation, these are very important. The coefficients in a balanced, remember, the coefficients in a balanced thermochemical equation refer to the number of moles of a substance of reactants and products involved in the reaction. Remember students, the coefficients means the number they used in a particular reaction is in a balanced thermochemical equation, it refers to the number of moles of a substance of reactants and products. The value of delta RH means change in the enthalpy of a reaction, it refers to the number of moles of a substance specified by an equation. Yes, next, very important, Hess law or Hess law of heat constant of summation. This is Hess law of constant heat summation. Students, according to this law, when a chemical reaction gets completed directly in one step or indirectly in two or more steps, the total enthalpy change in that particular reaction, it is same. The enthalpy change does not depend on path of a chemical reaction. Very important. Remember, the enthalpy is a state function. Here, the change in the enthalpy is independent of the path between initial state and the final state. In other words, this Hess law is easily defined as enthalpy change for a reaction is same. Remember, enthalpy change for a particular reaction is same whether that reaction is takes place or occurs in a single step or in a series of steps. Yes, if a reaction takes place in several steps, then its standard reaction enthalpy is the sum of all the standard enthalpies of the intermediate reactions into which the overall reaction may be divided into same temperature. Yes, remember the definition point. There is no change in the enthalpy of a reaction whether the reaction takes place in a single step or in multi-step. In general, if enthalpy of a overall reaction in a particular reaction A changes to B along one route, that is delta RH, delta RH1, right, H2, representing the enthalpies of reaction leading to the same product B. Along another route, then we have delta RH, means change in the enthalpy of a reaction is equal to first enthalpy change, second enthalpy change, etc. Right. Yes, next, standard enthalpy of combustion. Standard enthalpy of combustion. How do you define this term? What is enthalpy of combustion first? You know what is enthalpy of combustion. Amount of enthalpy released on total combustion of one mole of a substance at constant temperature. Right? Remember this concept. What is enthalpy of combustion? Amount of enthalpy released on total combustion of one mole of a substance at constant temperature is called enthalpy of combustion. Its value is always negative. Yes, if you take an example, combustion of hydrocarbons, all these values means change in the enthalpy values, it is always in negative. Yes, remember students, now the point is standard enthalpy of a combustion. Yes, these are exothermic in reaction because delta H value is always negative. These are the exothermic in nature. Standard enthalpy of a combustion is defined as the enthalpy change for mole of a substance when it undergoes combustion. Combustion means burning of a compound in the oxygen. And all the reactants and products being their standard state, it is represented as delta C, means combustion, H, delta H, they written C, change in the enthalpy of a combustion. Here dot or this zero, dot usually dot or zero, standard, it indicates standard values. Yes, next, another point, standard enthalpy of atomization. What is standard enthalpy of atomization? Students, the enthalpy change in the process of breaking of a bond. Remember, the enthalpy change observed in the process of breaking of a bond is called standard enthalpy of atomization. It is the enthalpy change on breaking one mole of bonds completely to obtained atoms in its gaseous phase. Usually standard enthalpy of atomization, it is the enthalpy change on breaking one mole of bonds completely to obtain it atoms in a gaseous phase. It is represented as delta HA. A means atomization. Change in the enthalpy of atomization. Yes, next, another term, bond enthalpy. What is bond enthalpy? Bond enthalpy in thermodynamics, it is divided into two parts. One is the bond dissociation enthalpy and another one mean bond enthalpy. For diatomic molecules, the enthalpy change involved in this process is bond dissociation enthalpy. Means, if you take an example, enthalpy of HH means between hydrogen molecule bond. The bond dissociation enthalpy is the change in enthalpy when one mole of covalent bonds of a gaseous covalent compound is broken and it forms products in the gaseous phase. Please go through the definition point of bond dissociation enthalpy and mean bond enthalpy by using your notes. Next, for polyatomic molecules, in this case we use the mean bond enthalpy of a carbon hydrogen bond. The reaction enthalpies are very important quantities as these arise from the changes that accompany the breaking of old bonds and formation of new bonds. Yes, see here one relation, that is summation of bond enthalpies reactants is equal to sum of bond enthalpies products. This relationship is particularly more useful when the required values are not available. Yes, next, enthalpy of a solution. Enthalpy of a solution. Yes, what is enthalpy of a solution? Usually, one mole of a substance is dissolved in such excess amount of water that no heat change takes place on further dilution. In this process, total heat change is called enthalpy of a solution. Yes, students, remember, enthalpy of a solution of a substance is the enthalpy change when one mole of it dissolved in the specified amount of solvent. The enthalpy of solution at infinite dilution is the enthalpy change observed on dissolving the substance in an infinite amount of solvent when the interactions between these ions are negligible. Another point, when an ionic compound is dissolved in a solvent, the ions leave their ordered position on their crystal lattice. I think this concept you may see in your solid state chapter. Yes, next, another point, lattice enthalpy. Yes, lattice enthalpy. What is lattice enthalpy? The lattice enthalpy of an ionic compound is the enthalpy change which occurs when one mole of ionic compound get dissociate into its ions in a gaseous state. Yes, NaCl, it gets converted to Na plus and Cl minus, right? Here lattice enthalpy is plus 788 kilojoule per mole. It is calculated by using Born-Haber cycle process. Remember, the lattice enthalpy of an ionic compound is the enthalpy change which occurs when one mole of an ionic compound dissociate into its ions in the gaseous state. Lattice enthalpy, it is impossible to determine the lattice enthalpies directly by an experiment. We can use it by indirect method, that is Born-Haber cycle. Yes, sodium chloride formation. See here, enthalpy diagram for lattice enthalpy of NaCl. You also studied in your chemical bonding chapter also, right? Born-Haber cycle. Next, spontaneity. Very important terms. Please carefully observe the points and use. These are very useful to solve the multiple choice questions. Yes, spontaneous process is an irreversible process and may only be reversed by an external agency. Decrease in the enthalpy is a criterion for spontaneity. I think you know this point. I explained by using a water flow example, right? Water flow from higher level to lower level. Yes, decrease in the enthalpy is a criterion for spontaneity. Remember, decrease in enthalpy may be contributory factor for a spontaneity, but it is not true for all the cases. Yes, a spontaneous reaction may be past one, but not may be the function of first one. Students, any two gases can combine to form a product, but the rate of spontaneity differs from equation to equation. All remember these points. Yes, next, entropy and spontaneity. What is entropy? It is the measurement of randomness. Yes, we introduce another thermodynamic function here that is called entropy, and it is indicated by S. Higher the isolation, higher is the entropy. The change in entropy accompanying a chemical reaction may be estimated qualitatively, taking some structures in mind. Students, a crystalline solid will have lowest entropy because here the arrangement of atoms is very tight, whereas in the gaseous state we have highest entropy. Entropy, like any other thermodynamic function, includes internal energy. Enthalpy is a state of function, delta S. It is independent of its path, change in the entropy. Whenever heat is added to the system, its molecular locations increase, causing randomness in the system. Thus, heat Q, it is randomizing effect. Temperature is the measure of average kinetic motion of particles in the system. As you know, mathematical representation, Q reversible by T, delta S change in the entropy. As delta S total change in the entropy, total change in the entropy is equal to change in the system. Change in the entropy of a system plus change in the entropy of its surroundings. When a system is in equilibrium, remember this is also very important. When a system is in equilibrium, the entropy is maximum and the change in entropy, that is zero. S gives energy and spontaneity. Students, we know that increase nor decrease in the entropy of a substance, it can determine the spontaneity process. I think you know the relation. G means Gibbs energy is equal to H minus TS. G equal to H minus TS. Gibbs is an extensive property and one of the state function. Therefore, change in the Gibbs energy for a system, it is used one formula, delta G equal to delta H minus T delta S. This is the equation which is used for calculate the change in the Gibbs free energy. Yes, this one, delta G equal to delta H minus T delta S. Remember this formula. This may help to calculate the change in the energy, Gibbs energy. Yes, remember delta G means change in the energy, Gibbs energy. It gives criterion for spontaneity at constant pressure and temperature. Remember these terms. If delta G is negative, the process is spontaneous. If delta G is positive, means greater than zero, the process is non-spontaneous. These are very important. Yes, if the reaction has positive enthalpy change and positive entropy change, it can be spontaneous. When T delta S is large, this value is large enough to outweigh delta H. This can happen in two ways. The positive entropy change of the system can be small, in which T can be large, temperature can be large. The positive entropy change of a system can be large, in which case T can be small. T here, T refers to the temperature. Gibbs energy change and equilibrium. What is the relationship between these two terms? Yes, here I take one example. Here, the criterion for the equilibrium reaction, A plus B changes to C plus T. Here it is equilibrium. It contains equilibrium sign, right? Hence here delta G change in the energy, Gibbs energy equal to 0. Gibbs energy for a reaction in which all the reactants are products are in standard state. Gibbs energy for a reaction in which all the reactant and products are in standard state. Here delta G naught, standard Gibbs energy, is related to the equilibrium constant of the reaction. Right? You know, and remember this final equation, delta G naught equal to minus 2.303 RT log K. It is one of the common factor, 2.303. Yes, in case of endothermic reactions, heat evolved will be large and positive. Remember, in case of endothermic reactions, heat evolved will be large and positive, where in case of exothermic reactions, heat evolved will be small and negative. Yes, therefore, depending upon the temperature and other factors like internal energy, entropy change, and rate of kinetic diffusion, the entropy changes is determined. Students, it is possible to estimate the value of delta G naught from the measurement of delta H and delta S naught, means standard change in the entropy and standard change in the enthalpy, and calculate the value of K at any temperature for economic yields of the products. If K is measured directly in the laboratory, then the value of delta G naught at any other temperature can be calculated easily. Okay, students, these are the some theoretical concepts which already you learnt in your previous year, means in the first PUC, right? In the next video, we'll solve some multiple choice questions which are already present in already provided material. Thank you.